In this video, we're going to show you our workflow and strategy for getting the most out of customer testimonials. So if you're shooting one or you've got a huge library from the past, we're going to show you how to repurpose those and get a ton of content for your social media and website. So typically a customer interview lasts about 20 minutes. Now on the screen, you're seeing Premiere Pro, and we've put this interview on a timeline. The first thing we're going to do is watch this interview in full all the way through. And every time we see a section that might be good, we'll make a cut and then highlight the video depending on how good that clip is. Now, a tip for this is to hit the L button to speed up your playback. That way you don't have to sit through the whole thing in real time. Now, typically you take these clips, you rearrange them into a story, put some music on it, some B-roll, and then you have a case study video. Now, case study videos are a great marketing tool, but there's a ton more you can do with this interview. Now, let's go back to that interview. Now, what you find is out of all the clips we highlighted, you probably only used a third or a quarter of them in the case study video. But all these clips can be used as separate videos. You can create ads out of them, you can create product videos, but I think the most powerful and easiest way is to create short form content for your social media, like your in-feed posts and YouTube Shorts, Instagram Reels. So turning these clips into short form videos is really easy. The first thing you're gonna wanna do is take that clip, create a new sequence in square or vertical format. Go ahead and reposition your subject so it's better framed within the composition. And then for editing, really all you need to do is add those captions. Now, Adobe Premiere Pro has a really awesome feature that automatically transcribes your footage. It's in the text panel. All you need to do is click on it, and in the background, it's gonna listen to your audio, and if it's good, it's usually gonna do a pretty good job of transcribing that. Now that we have our transcript, first we're gonna wanna create a text style that we like, that we want all our captions to look like. Now, I usually recommend a sans serif font with an outline or backgrounds so that it stands out on any type of footage. Once we're happy with our text style, we can save it, and then we'll go over to the Create Captions panel. In the Create Captions panel, we'll select our text style. I like using single line captions, and then I like lowering the maximum characters so that there's less words on screen. Now, Adobe Premiere is going to create captions automatically and sync them with your video. They usually do a pretty good job, but you're gonna wanna go ahead and watch your clip completely through and then move any of the text if, for example, it cuts at the wrong spot. The last thing I'd like to do is add emphasis on color. I'll pick out a keyword in each caption so that the viewer can quickly understand what's going on.
So I was pretty impressed, and they were able to get everything done, like I said, in half a day.
So a few more tips before we wrap up. Instead of it just being a talking video, you can add B-roll, you can add stock footage to these short form contents. That's another great way to up the quality and better tell their story. I also like to take the entire interview, get it transcribed, and then send it to the marketing team. They can easily pull quotes from this and use it in graphics and social media posts. And then lastly, when you film that customer testimonial, make sure you get a signed release from them that you can use it in your marketing materials. All right, so thanks for watching the video. If you have any questions, make sure to comment down below and we'll do our best to answer them all.